This is the day the Lord hath made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Almighty God, we give you praise, we give you all the honor, and we give you all the glory. We thank you for allowing us to see this first day of June 2021. Lord, we ask you have your divine way at this moment. We ask that you anoint me to minister your word to your people with precision and with clarity. Anoint each and every ear to hear and touch every heart to receive what you're saying at this moment. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. This is a blessed day. Every day above ground is a blessed day. I want to talk to you today about separated for a greater experience and knowledge with God. Separated for a greater experience and knowledge with God. I want to give you Exodus chapter 34, verse 1 to 5, and verse 29 and 30. Exodus 34, verse 1 to 5, 29 and 30. But I want to start out with 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 2 and verse 7. The Apostle Paul was separated for a greater experience and to get some more knowledge about God. I believe in my spirit that God has called many of you that are listening to me this morning to separate yourself, not because you're better than others, but just for a moment in this journey to separate yourself to get a greater experience with God and to get more knowledge about him. It's a very important time in your life. And yes, some of you are struggling to do that. You're struggling. But the living God is saying to you today, you have to do it in order to go into the next dimension of your Christian journey. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 2 and verse 7. The Apostle Paul, under the unction of the Holy Spirit, he wrote these words. I knew a man in Christ about 14 years ago. Whether in the body, I cannot tell. Or whether out of the body, I cannot tell. God know it. Such an one caught up to the third heaven. Verse 7. Unless I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan, to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure. Paul was writing about his own life experience. The Apostle Paul, if you remember in the book of Acts, he died and came back alive in the presence of some people. In that moment, he was caught up to the third heaven. He also let us know that to be with Christ is far better. He had an experience with the Lord. He came back with an abundance of revelations. And the living God put a thorn in his flesh to keep him humble. Good God Almighty. Anytime God calls you into a higher dimension, he must give you an experience so that you can function in that higher dimension. Paul went through that. Now look at Revelation chapter 4. You remember the Apostle John? Revelation chapter 4, verse 1. After this, I looked and behold, a door was opened in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was at it work of a trumpet talking with me, which said, come up hither, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter. The Apostle Paul, after writing the letters to the seven churches in Asia Minor, God gave him an experience in the third heaven and showed him things which must come after. And you know the book of Revelation. The Apostle John saw a lot of the future. He had an experience with God. God is calling you to a higher dimension. But in order for you to operate in a higher dimension, he must separate you from some things. He must separate you from some people for a period of time so that he can reveal to you some things. Good God Almighty, are you ready to move to the higher dimension? If your answer is yes, you're saying, Dr. Ambrose, I am ready to go through a moment of separation just between you and God. This might be your secret closet out of all of the secret closets that you have. Good God Almighty. A moment on this journey where it is just you and God. God speaking with you. God giving you revelations that you have never heard of. God is taking you to a higher dimension. Look at Matthew chapter 17. Start at verse 1. And after 6 days, Jesus taketh Peter, James, and John, his brother, and bringeth them up into a high mountain apart. And Jesus was transfigured before them. Good God. He completely changed his form and appearance before Peter, James, and John. He changed into a more beautiful and spiritual state. Good God Almighty. He was more radiant in glory before them. He was transfigured before them. And his face did shine as the sun. And his raiment was white as the light. And behold, there appeared unto them Moses and Elijah talking with Jesus. He took them from where they were to a high mountain and gave them an experience and a greater knowledge of Jesus himself. Good God. Peter went on and said, Lord, allow us to build three tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. But he heard a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved son. Don't get carried away. Moses was a great man. Elijah was very great, but Jesus is the one. They get a deeper revelation of who Jesus was. Greater than Moses, greater than Elijah. And they saw him in a more radiant glory upon that mountain. When it came back down, you know they were different. When God separates you, and God filled you with that experience that he had in store for you, when you come back down, you're going to come back with a greater knowledge about Jesus, a greater experience. Your ministry will never be the same again. Good God Almighty. Exodus chapter 34. Look at verse 1-5. And verse 29 and 30. And the Lord said unto Moses, hew thee two tables of stone like unto the first, and I will write upon these tables the words that were in the first tables which thou breakest. I want you to listen carefully. Talk about tables, tablets of stones. But I want you to see yourself. Those tablets, those tables of stones are your heart. I want you to get these stones because I'm going to write something on these stones. The same thing that you break before Moses, I'm going to write them on these stones. David said, a word have I hidden in my heart. Your tables of stone today are your heart. The Lord is speaking to somebody. He has given you some things in your heart. You break them, but now he's calling you into a place where you can rewrite those things in your heart again. Thank God for another chance. Look at verse 2. And be ready in the morning. This is a divine appointment for somebody. Be ready in the morning. Don't put it off anymore. Be ready in the morning and come in the morning onto Mount Sinai. Some of you might have to postpone some of your plans that you had. And present thyself dear to me in the top of the mount. This is an invitation for somebody. An invitation to separate yourself. Yes, you have been contemplating for a long time. You said you were going to do it in January. You did not. You said you were going to do it in February. You did not. You said the same thing in March, April, and May. Now, this is June 1st, 2021, and the Lord is saying to somebody today, I want you to do it tomorrow in the morning. Good God Almighty. Look at verse 3. And no man shall come up with thee. Don't wait for nobody. Don't bring nobody with you. I want you to separate yourself, good God Almighty, because I'm going to give you an experience. I'm going to fill you with abundance of knowledge and revelations so you can function in the next dimension. Don't bring anyone with you. No man shall come with thee, neither let any man be seen throughout all the mount. I don't even want them close. I don't want nobody interfering with this moment that I want to have with you, said the Lord. Don't let anyone be seen. Don't let no one see you on Zoom. Don't let nobody call you on the telephone. Don't get on no Facebook. Good God Almighty. No one should be seen throughout all the mount. This is a moment with you and God alone. Neither let the flocks nor herds feed before that mount. Moses, I know you have a lot of sheep that you're tending to, but I don't even want your sheep close to you. Yes, pastors, I know you have a lot of sheep. I know you have a lot of people in your congregation. I know they're concerned about you, but I don't want them to be close to you in this moment. Good God Almighty. And he hewed two tables of stone like unto the first. And Moses rose up early in the morning and went up unto Mount Sinai as the Lord had commanded him. I want to spend a little time there. The Lord had commanded him. Because many times people believe, amen, that they can compromise, good God Almighty, they can kind of tell God where they want to go when God already command you to go where he wants you to go. Oh, God, thank you. Sometimes we want to do things in our own time, when it's convenient for us, when God already command us a certain time. Let me get a little closer to some of you today, because it is so important. Let's go to church service. You told me that service starts at 10. You told people that service starts at 10. God is expecting you at 10 o'clock. Now, you're all there by yourself. It is you and God. That is a moment between you and God. But you delayed because other people are not there by 10. I want to say to you, especially those of you that are in leadership, once you have a commitment to God that this is the time you're going to start your worship. If it's 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, whatever time it is, this is the time you are going to start your worship service. In spite of who is there with you, in spite of the musicians are not there, the praise leader is not there, you have a commitment with God that this is the time you're going to start worship. I'm saying to you this morning, if you are the only one in the house, that might just be the moment that God is going to do something great in your life. Good God Almighty. Too many people, they delayed, they moved their time to suit people. And many of you have tried it. You have moved time to suit people and you miss God. Because that is not the time that God commanded you to do. Good God Almighty. I want to say to you, look at verse 4 again. He hewed out two tables of stone like unto the first, and Moses rose up early in the morning and went up unto Mount Sinai as the Lord had commanded him. What did God command you to do? Good God Almighty. Sometimes God keeps people away for a reason. What time? He said morning, not afternoon, not midday. What time did he command you to get to the mount? What time did he command you to pray? What did God put in your spirit? You don't need nobody else with you. This is between you and God. This is your time of separation for greater experience and greater knowledge with God. God wants to put some things in your spirit at that time. That's the reason why he commanded that time and that place. As the Lord had commanded him and took in his hand the two tables of stone. Look at verse 5. And the Lord descended in the cloud and stood with Moses there and proclaimed the name of the Lord. I don't want the living God to show up at the time that he commanded me, and I am not there. Yes, some people may not be there, but you don't want the Lord to show up, and you are not there. Instead, you want to get there early, good God Almighty, so that you don't miss God. How many times we disobey God, and we expect that God is going to show up in our time? Good God Almighty. How many times, amen, we try to please people? We get out of line with God. When God wants to separate you for a great experience and abundance of knowledge with him, it's a moment with him alone. But how many times we compromise that and we miss God? And we're fighting and try to swim to get to the shore because we miss God. Good God Almighty. Look at verse 29 and verse 30 of the same chapter, Exodus chapter 34. Good God Almighty. Verse 29 says, "And it came to pass when Moses came down from Mount Sinai with the two tables of testimony in Moses' hand, when he came down from the mount, that Moses wist not that the skin of his face shone while he talked with him." He had no idea that a transfiguration took place in his life. He had no idea that the radiance of God was upon him and he was shining. Verse 30. "And when Aaron and all the children of Israel saw Moses, behold, the skin of his face shone, and they were afraid to come nigh to him." God is going to use you in a greater dimension. I know the Bible says we are the light of the world. But the Bible also said, "Let your light so shine before men, just like a city that is set on a hill," where people from all around will see the light in you, will see the glory of God upon your life. Yes, some of you might be satisfied of where you are right now, with a little glory, with a little knowledge. But God is calling you, amen, into a higher place. God is going to use your body, good God Almighty. He's going to use your vessel in a greater dimension. You are the temple of God. Your life is not your own anymore. And just like Jesus transfigured himself on that mountain before Peter, James, and John, just like the glory was more visible on that mountain, good God Almighty, just like he was transfigured in his appearance, good God Almighty, he was transfigured, hallelujah, in his form, and they saw him in a more spiritual state. They saw him in a more beautiful state. God is saying to you today, that's how he wants to use you here on this earth. Good God Almighty. Now, let me say that again a little more slow. The same way Jesus was transfigured before Peter, James, and John on the Mount of Transfiguration, when they saw him in a more beautiful state, they saw him in a more spiritual state. The reason why God is calling you mountain. Moses had an experience. He shined brighter than ever before. The living God is saying to you today, when you take time and you get into the place where it is just you and God, when you come back down from that place, the living God will work through you where people will see a transfiguration in you. Remember, it is not you, but it is God in you. They will see you in a more beautiful state. They will see you in a greater dimension. Your face will shine greater than before. Your ministry will shine greater than before. The abundance of revelation that Paul experienced will be in you greater than before. Just like he showed the Apostle John, the future, God will use you in that dimension, good God, in a greater dimension. He wants to take you into an experience that you never had before. More revelation, more insight in the future, good God Almighty, a more radiance of your appearance, a more spiritual state that people will know it is Jesus in you, transfiguring himself in you and bringing out the radiance, bringing out the anointing, your prophetic ministry. Good God Almighty, and some of you are listening to me right now that God is using in the prophetic, your prophetic ministry. Just like the Apostle John, he saw things in the future and he was able to write what is going to take place in the future. Your prophetic ministry is going to come forth in a higher dimension. You will be more accurate. Good God Almighty, you will be more timely. People are going to run to you. They're going to read your writing. Good God Almighty, you will operate in a higher dimension. You've got some people are prophesying other things that are already taking place. But you're going to prophesy and tell them what the future holds. Good God Almighty, you're going to prophesy to the nations. You're going to prophesy to the congregation that you're in. You're going to prophesy to the community that you're in, and people are going to run to you because you had an experience with a living God. Good God Almighty, separated for a greater experience and greater knowledge with God. Are you willing to go to that mountain? Are you willing to separate yourself? Good God, just between you and God, so God can fill you with more of him. So that the transfiguration of Jesus can be seen through you by the way you shine, the abundance of revelation, and the prophetic ministry that will be evident in your life. Your answer is yes, I could hear you. I am willing to go to the next dimension. I am willing to function in the next dimension. Say, yes, Lord, your invitation is accepted. I will, you will. We all will separate ourselves for greater experience and knowledge with God. Lord, we thank you. We praise yourself and we magnify your name. We thank you for this moment. We thank you for every ear that heard and every heart that received. Let your will be done in our life, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.